Well, he was fired, then he was rehired as the dust begins to settle on a landslide election victory. An emboldened Donald Trump has claimed a powerful mandate that will reshape America and the world as Kamala Harris vows to keep on fighting.
Defeated.
It is okay to feel sad and disappointed, but please know it's going to be okay.
But not finished.
Sometimes the fight takes a while. That doesn't mean we won't win.
For us as women, it's all about just sticking together.
It's crushing.
This is not a time to throw up our hands. This is a time to roll up our sleeves.
VP Kamala Harris formally conceding the election as Donald Trump cruised to a crushing victory.
America has given us an unprecedented and powerful mandate.
The White House and the Senate reclaimed.
Wow, that's great.
Trump's party on track to retain the House and total government control.
We're going to have the most aggressive first 100 days agenda that anybody's seen in the modern era. And we got to fix everything, everything.
All eyes now on who Trump will appoint as his top team. Among those singled out, UFC boss Dana White.
This is what happens when the machine comes after you.
Elon Musk as an advisor on spending cuts.
A star is born, Elon.
Let that sink in, Musk posted on Twitter. While prominent vaccine skeptic Robert Kennedy Jr. has been tapped to
help make America healthy again.
Democrats, Republicans, the world reacting.
Yeah, I once again want to reiterate my congratulations to President Trump.
How anybody could vote for a rapist, how anybody could vote for a convicted felon. I just don't know.
Feelings of triumph for some.
This is a victory. This is a victory. Big victory.
For others, despair. As we await Trump 2.0.
Good things are coming. Whether you voted for him or not, you'll see a change in this country and hopefully the world.
Wow. Will it be a good change?
Well, I know nothing about politics, but I know a lot about the UFC. And the yes. UFC president...
How did we book you, Nick? What a
finally, mixed martial arts in schools. Is that what I'm hearing? It's about time.
Who is this? Like, I'd literally never seen or heard of Dana White until last night. It sounds... You know, we're doing the election broadcast and
this is why it needs to be in school.
This is the head of the UFC being brought on in during the victory speech.
Mm. Yes.
Like, what's he doing there? How did he get there?
Well, the UFC wasn't an accepted sport in its early days in a lot of states in the US, and I believe New Jersey said it was all good to go in about 2001, and Trump let Dana White know that he could use his casinos to put on the events in those early days and back the UFC before it became what's now a $6 or $7 billion company.
The bromance was forged then.
Mm.
There's something so wild about, you know, seeing UFC bosses and Kennedy and even Elon Musk maybe part of the administration, but then...
Maybe Hulk Hogan too.
yeah, you never know. You know, there's also a part of America, I think most Aussies, if you ever go there or look at it, mm-hmm. You kind of see that a lot of it doesn't work. Like, if you go on holidays to America, you don't want to end up in one of their hospitals.
Totally.
You can see what it's like. You can see what the roads are like. You see what the broader transport system's like. You see this huge, hulking federal bureaucracy. And you're like, is this really working for Americans? So even though bits of this, I think, for us seem a bit hard to kind of fathom, there's also another part of it that makes me think, well, you can see why Americans really wanted to disrupt it.
I need something this radical to do that.
Cage fighting.
You know what runs flawlessly? UFC events. I've been to heaps. They are schmick.
Incredible.